intoxicating qualities. It's also a federal crime to say something so annoying to someone that it makes them hit you in a national forest. It's also a federal crime to injure a government-owned lamp. Why are any of these ridiculous federal crimes important? Because if you commit a felony, your right to vote can be stripped away from you. Today I'm here to talk to you about felon disenfranchisement laws, how they vary from state to state, why it's a problem that they vary so much, and what we can do to correct this problem. There are five main types of felony disenfranchisement. In 10 states, ex-felons may lose the right to vote permanently. In 20 states, including Missouri, vote is restored after prison, parole, and probation. In 4 states, the right to vote is restored after prison term and parole. In 14 states and Washington, D.C., the right to vote is restored after their prison term, and only in 2 states, Maine and Vermont, are you allowed to vote from prison. But what constitutes a felony isn't the same from state to state either. So the complexities of these laws, just in their 5 categories, is enough to make any person wonder whether or not they'd be able to vote, depending on what the severity of their crime is. But in some states, it's a certain number of strikes. 3 strikes, you're out. You can't vote anymore. It doesn't matter what you did. In some states, it's only violent crimes that you're not allowed to vote anymore. So these laws are targeting minorities, and they're targeting the poor, because oftentimes you have to pay penalties when you are convicted felon. And if you're poor and just out of prison and you have a felony on your record, what's the likelihood that you're going to get a job quickly? It's going to be years before you can even apply to get your vote back. And why is this actually a problem for those of us in this room, for college students across America? Marijuana. Marijuana is the problem because, as this graph shows you, you can have any number of grams of marijuana on you for it to be considered a felony. And in states like Arizona, when you got the 3 strike rule, just smoking pot 3 times and getting caught is going to take away your right to vote for the rest of your life. There's a professor here that I had in my time at Southeast who told me a story about a colleague who taught with her in a different university in a different state. He was unable to vote because of smoking marijuana a number of times, but he was allowed to teach. Doesn't that seem like a problem? That he can teach political science and can teach about how important it is to vote, but he can't vote because when he was 18, he smoked a little bit too much pot. It's ridiculous. And it's a serious problem facing the United States. If you are able to rejoin society, and you're able to hold a job, and you're deemed fit to be out in the open and out with everyone else, why can't you vote? In my opinion, the right to vote should be restored after prison sentences, and it should be the same across all of the United States. It isn't fair to those who have committed nonviolent crimes and who are underprivileged and poor that they're no longer able to vote for something they did when they were young or when they were stupid and that they didn't understand the full consequences of. But another problem with this is that if you move, your laws change. If you move from Missouri to Arizona, you can lose your right to vote. If you move from Florida to California, you can lose your right to vote, and you have to reapply again and again. This is a huge problem for the United States, and I know I keep saying that, but that's how important this is. And people don't understand that, and that's how we're going to fix this. We need to get the word out about felony disenfranchisement and the complexity of its laws. If we can get the word out, people will feel motivated to become activists about it and to be passionate and be able to give speeches like I am today about how important it is to write to your legislators about changing laws, about making them uniform, so that we give everyone the same opportunity that we were given because we were fortunate enough to go to college and learn about these things. Felony disenfranchisement is a problem most people will never think about and will never affect their lives. But the laws surrounding it are so complex that it needs to be fixed. It marginalizes minorities and the poor, even more than they already are. To fight this injustice, we need to raise awareness And the first step is allowing everyone to know their when their constitutional rights are in jeopardy. Thank you.
Floor is open for questions.
May I ask, what made you interested in this topic in the first place?
Thank you, Benjamin. That's a great question. Benjamin's question was, what made me interested in this topic? I wanted to go to law school, and when I was thinking about what type of law I wanted to practice, I initially wanted to be an appellate court judge. And so the differences of the cases you can get at that level made me interested in a whole bunch of different types of law. And so that's kind of how I stumbled across this. Does that answer your question?
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you. Yes, Darren?
Okay, so I know you said that we can talk to like our congressmen in order to like change the laws. Do you know of any other ways that we would be able to make a step towards changing the felony disenfranchisement?
Thank you, Darian. That's a great question. Darian's question is if there's anything else we can do besides talking to our legislators and to change the law. And there's not a whole lot we can do. We can sign petitions and we can talk to our legislators because in the end, they need to be the ones that write and change the law, and so we need to make enough of a movement for them to take notice. Does that answer your question?
Yes, it did.
Thank you.
Do you think there are the marijuana in the outline? What are some other problems that you think, I guess, from a younger age would be
causing another issue? Yeah, that's a great question. Johnson's question was, besides marijuana, what are some other issues that can create this problem? And in some states, car theft and breaking and entering while serious crimes won't get you disenfranchised, but some of them will. Those tend to be